Completely agree with Joe. I do think this add some questions. Who's going to make it through the group? Starhorn Real Club came out. They completely outplayed TSM. They were extremely aggressive, got in their faces. And I think TSM was doomed from the start. They had never seen a good Rengar before.
True.
North America tried. Freak. you know, Crumbs tried twice.
Let me tell you, I pulled out my notebook.
2-9-13 on your Rengar stats. You were particularly impressed by Insec. What was he doing right
there? I wrote it all down so that I can bring it back to NA. Maybe try to do it. But one of the biggest differences I noticed is that in NA, everybody's building CDR, like, oh, let's just get more ultimates so that we can gank more. He did not do any of that. He was only thinking about, I'm just going to make my gank as effective as possible, building more damage, building mobility boots really early. And another difference is that he did not care at all about the little exclamation mark that pops up when you're ulting on Rengar. He's just like, well, I'm here. Yeah, deal with it. Like, he tower dive and Darius would clearly see him enter tower range and then just go gank him. That's the biggest thing that I saw. And he carried.
Yeah, I completely agree.
Something that worries me, though, for Royal Club is the Nidalee ban.
Yeah.
A lot pointed out by a lot of people on social media already. If you do your research against TSM, it's very likely that you don't need to. Maybe they were worried about like an off-season like training pick, and that was their kryptonite or something. But it either shows a lack of research or just distinct lack of respect. Either way, it was odd.
And the fun thing is, on the same side, TSM did their own research. It's not a champion that Kola plays. This is the first time in a long time TSM didn't ban Nidalee. And yeah, it's just very strange that it went over to the blue side. So even though I praised SHRC's pre-game planning just in the last game, because I thought their team comp was really clever in their first game of the group stage, this was a red flag that something was kind of amiss with these guys.
In terms of mid-game, I do think if TSM was able to hang on a little more to get Bjergsen strong enough, decent elite, and then start split-pushing, they could have done something, but their bot lane just fell so far behind. I know a lot of people want to point out little things about this, but I had the liberty of watching just what went wrong early. First of all, I want to point out, if you play with Zillion, bot lane actually does not level up to 2. Sooner, only level 3 is one creep earlier, but they just lost. They lost the first wave push, set them behind, led to a little poke. They were going okay, but then at level 3, Lost Boy skilled 2 points into his heal. They initiated a trade, and I think Insec immediately realized that was a rank 2 heal, and he jumped in immediately. Had no fear of the bubble because there was no bubble to be used, and they won a disgusting trade. And from that point, that lane was over.
And yeah, it was something Uzi. You called out, Monty, talking about the matchup between Wild Turtle and Uzi.
Yeah, this is when we were talking about the World Preview show, and we were talking about kind of focusing on the AD carries in this group. Wild Turtle's laning was a problem throughout the entire playoffs, and we were looking at massive CS differences between Uzi and Turtle, as well as that big pressure advantage. And as soon as that first gank got off, that really freed up Rengar to be in the top side a lot, get that Aurelia rolling, to the degree that when the Zed split push finally came, Aurelia just 1v1 Bjergsen. And at that point, there's not much you can do.
And part of the reason that led, I mean, you lined up a replay.
So Kola got incredibly fed. Let's actually pull up the replay. It's of the bottom lane teleport triple kill. It's really actually a lot of it's incredible. So first of all, the thing to point out is that Kola is actually already setting up the teleport. He shoved the wave. He's in the top lane brush near Dyrus. He's actually going to run down towards the brush in the middle to make sure Dyrus can't flash Rune Prison him. He's actually already doing this before the battle has started. The second thing to point out here is that Uzi is going to be the one who initiates the fight, saying, look, I know I can't die. We see Dyrus, we see Bjergsen. If we get ganked by Elise, then Insect can follow up, which makes it very, very clever, and they bait in the fight. So roll the clip out, and it's going to be the start of a good trade, and then Uzi's going to say, you know what, actually, we can go in and take this battle. We're paused briefly for a second, but he's going to basically rocket jump in after realizing it's a good trade. Essentially baits in Amazing afterwards, and suddenly, surprise, by the way, Rengar's here. TP has already come in again, and that is Kola, who's in Fog of War, cannot possibly be stopped. Dyrus only now starts, but he's already lost 2 people on his team, so there's no possible way that goes any better for TSM.
Yeah.
At this point, Kola's got a bunch of kills. He can always handle the split push.
And that's actually something that Krepa was talking about much earlier in the day, is just how quick the reaction speed is from the Asian squad's teleports from the top laners.
Well, to be fair, at that point, I was pointing out the things I saw in the Korean matches, but this was exactly what we mean here. Fight breaks was immediate, zero hesitation teleport. Sure, sometimes it might be wrong, but like it was the right call. You saw Dyrus, he was a full 4 seconds behind on his TP.
Even if it's wrong, he can just TP to the Dragon Pit because he already pushed in the top wave, so they can just secure a dragon while Dyrus has to address the wave top. So no matter if there was no kill in that bot lane, that's a free dragon.
Yep. Yeah, well, we are going to have to move on.